as we age, we have more and more requirements when it comes to our health. And for us ladies, we of course need mammograms after the age of 40, but that's not all you need to know.
Dr. Avital Harari is here to talk about what to do to help prevent breast cancer. And the question that I have is should we start with genetics? Are we to know everything we need to know about ourselves before you launch into this whole thing? Because people Google breast cancer and what should I do? Where should we start?
So, as you just mentioned, we basically start screening for breast cancer in the majority of women at the age of 40. The screening recommendations kind of are dependent on your risk factors. If you're at higher risk for breast cancer and if you're at regular risk for breast cancer. So all comers, one out of eight women will develop breast cancer in their life, but seven out of eight won't. So how do you know if you're going to be one of those people? You don't really, but there are risk factors that make you at the higher risk of getting breast cancer.
Like what?
So higher risks are any first degree family member. So if your mother, sister, daughter, there's male breast cancer too.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's
of course
any man in your family that had breast cancer, that puts that family at higher risk. Other things like having an earlier onset of menarche, like your period, mm-hmm. and a late menopause. So the longer you have hormones in your system, that's a slightly higher risk. People who are on hormone replacement therapy after menopause, they have slightly higher risk. And there's a whole risk stratification. It's called the Gale risk stratifications that you can look online.
Okay, so let's just say I'm not yet 40. Lord willing. Not yet 40. I walk into the doctor and, you know, maybe my sister, or no, I'm sorry, my mother, let's just say that, mm-hmm. or my grandmother mm-hmm. had breast cancer. What's the likelihood that I would have it?
It's unclear. I mean, the closer the relative is to you, the higher the risk. So it could be up to 20 to 25%. And it depends on if you have a genetic, like a genetic defect.
Like, you mean like what happened to Angelina Jolie, right?
Yes.
That BRCA gene, is
that's
that what you're
right.
talking about?
Yeah. So the BRCA gene, definitely. So anybody who has like a first degree relative should probably be screened for that. Mm-hmm. It's not the only gene that can increase your risk of breast cancer. There's a series of genes that we know about now, but the BRCA gene is specifically the highest risk for all the genetic disorders. So if you have or carry that gene, you might do a lot more to prophylactically, you know, prevent it.
Is the breast cancer mammogram the only tool that you have to detect it or to prevent it?
No. So there are other tools. So if you're at the regular risk category, typically the recommendation from the American Cancer Society is to start screening at the age of 40, once a year with a mammogram. And then it can be every other year after age 55 sometimes, depending on your choice. If you're at higher risk, you're going to be screened much more frequently. So it'll likely be every 6 months, and you'll do probably an MRI, and then you'll do a mammogram with ultrasound. So those three...
There's no blood test in there?
Not yet.
Interesting.
No, we don't have. I mean, the people are researching, you know, circulating tumor cells and cancers to try and detect cancers earlier, but this is the best thing that we have. And the reason we do all three of those is that, you know, denser breasts might not show up as well on mammograms. And sometimes a cancer in a mammogram will be showing up, but the MRI won't show up. And so if you're at really high risk, you're going to be doing more. More often.
More testing. Let's talk about survivability of breast cancer, mm-hmm. because I feel like the technology has come to a place now where it is more likely that you can survive from breast cancer than, let's say, 10 years ago.
I think that's overall true because we're detecting them earlier. So the earlier you detect it, the more likely you could even cure it. And if you detect it very late stages, obviously that's a separate situation where it's going to affect your mortality. But even so, there are medications and chemotherapy agents and hormonal agents that can keep it at bay a lot of times, so that it becomes more of a chronic illness. There's also medications that high-risk people can do to prevent breast cancer.
Really?
Mm-hmm. They're tamoxifen or raloxifene, I think it's called. And those are two things that some people that are very high risk might take for a certain period of time. And it basically adjusts. It's all about the hormones and how they affect your breasts and how you can treat.
Mm-hmm. Very
interesting. Dr. Avital Harari, thanks so much for bringing
you for
really good
in.
Information.
You're welcome.